Hello and welcome everyone. In this video tutorial for chapter pressure, we have already studied what is force and friction, in which we have studied about what is force, its types, friction and its types. Now we are going to start a topic related to force and friction, which is pressure. Here we will study about the power and nature of pressure. From the word, the pressure, I don't mean the burden of physical or mental distress. The stress or urgency of matters demanding attention, strain or tension, and not even stomach pressure. No. We are not going to discuss any of such things. Here, we are not talking about pressure or tension you gain after watching your exam question paper. Definitely not. But we will be dealing with pressure in terms of physics, the action of a force against an opposing force. The force or thrust exerted over a surface divided by its area. The pressure exerted in every direction by the weight of the atmosphere. A sensation aroused by moderate compression of a body part or surface. When we move on sand, our feet sink into it and it is difficult for us to walk. On the other hand, a camel, which is much heavier than us, can walk on sand easily. This is because a camel has broad feet. It is easy to cut fruit and vegetables with a sharp knife than with a blunt one. This happens because a blunt knife has a larger area of contact. High heels concentrate a large amount of force into a small area. The great pressure transmitted through such a heel can make you feel uncomfortable while walking on a soft or sandy surface. From the above examples, we can conclude that the effect of force depends upon the area of contact of the two objects. Lesser the area of the contact, more is the effect of force, and vice versa. That is why it is easy to push a sharpened pencil into the soil, as the area over which the force is applied is small, hence increasing the effect of force on it. We can measure the effect of force using a physical quantity called pressure. So, the pressure is defined as the physical force exerted on an object. The force applied is perpendicular to the surface of objects per unit area. Another definition, pressure is defined as the force acting on a unit area of a surface. Using this definition, the formula which can be decoded here is pressure is equal to force divided by area on which force is acting. The SI unit of pressure is Pascal, short form PA. Thus, 1 Pascal is the pressure applied when force of 1 Newton acts on an area of 1 meter square. Look at the dummy. He wishes to hang a painting on the wall. For it, he first used a pin, a bottle-shaped wooden object used in a bowling game. Later on, with some good advice, he used a nail. Now, because the nail has a sharp and pointed end, it will penetrate inside the wall very easily with each stroke of the hammer. So it proves that lesser area of contact more is the effect of force. In another example, look at the blue surface and the pressure reading. As the area of the surface decreases, reading in the pressure gauge increases. In another example, look at the watermelon. These two gentlemen are trying to cover it with the elastic rubber bands. But what they actually did is they are applying a huge amount of pressure at a single point on the watermelon surface. Because of the force applied by many rubber bands on a small area, it burst into pieces. Similarly, look at the drum. Now, this drum is explaining atmospheric pressure. First, a little amount of water, nearly 2 to 3 liter, was added to it and heated, due to which water inside would vaporize and newly formed water vapors will force air inside the drum to leave from the drum. Now close the lid of the drum and pour cold water on it. Due to cold water, water vapors inside the drum will condense and would create a vacuum inside the drum. Rest is air pressure. Technically, the drum have a surface area of about 3000 square inches. The force of one atmospheric pressure on that surface is about 44,000 pounds, or simply 22 ton. In the description section of this video, I will place few links. Using these links, you can go through few videos and informations. When we increase the area over which force is applied, the pressure decreases. Similarly, a decrease in the contact area increases the pressure. We can observe this relationship between pressure and area in many day-to-day activities. The width of the straps of bags and suitcases is increased to reduce pressure while carrying them. The wheels of military tankers are covered with a broad rubber strip so that they do not sink in the sand or snow. It is more comfortable to wear broad heels while walking on soft surfaces. Elephants and bears have broad feet to help them walk on soft surfaces without falling. Solids have a definite shape, and the pressure exerted by them depends on the contact area. However, liquids do not have a definite shape. The pressure exerted by them depends upon the depth of the water column. They exert pressure not only at the base of the container, but also on its sides. This is shown in this video. You can try this activity at home also. Take a plastic bottle and punch 3 or 4 holes at different height. Now pour some water into it and let the water flow through these holes. You will observe that water from the lowest hole comes out with the greatest force and falls at the maximum distance. You will observe that water from the topmost hole comes out with the least force and falls at the minimum distance. This activity proves that liquid pressure varies with depth. The pressure increases with depth of the liquid. This is the reason why deep sea divers wear special suits to protect themselves from increasing water pressure. Same vacuum and pressure is applicable here. If we close the lid, there is no way air can enter inside. Hence, water will not flow out of the bottle. And if you open the lid of the bottle, water will flow out of it because air is allowed to pass into it. While bathing, most of you have tried this experiment. You have tried to push the inverted mug inside the water. The more you try, the more water resists. This resistance is the upthrust. The property of a fluid to exert an upward force on a body that is wholly or partially submerged in it is called buoyancy. Buoyancy is the force that keeps things afloat. When you try to push an inverted glass in a bucket full of water, the glass resists being pushed down into the water. This happens because the force exerted by the water on the glass is much more than the force exerted by you. Thus, the upward force of water resists the downward movement of the glass. So we can say that pressure at any point under a liquid is because of the weight of the liquid column above the point. You must have observed that a feather float on water while a stone sinks in it. This happens because whenever an object is immersed in a liquid, it experiences a net upward force by the liquid. This upward force decides whether an object will sink or float in the liquid. If the weight of the object is less than the upward force, then the object will float, otherwise it will sink. We have already learned that liquid exerts pressure. In the same way, gases also exert pressure. That is why a balloon expands when we blow air in it. But what happens if we blow too much air in the balloon? It bursts. This happens because the material of the balloon is not able to withstand or hold the increasing pressure of the air. The molecules of gas has higher energy, due to which they collide with walls applying large force. As a result, these molecules apply pressure on the walls of the container. This is the first reason why balloon inflates. And when the wall of the balloon is not able to hold the pressure, it explodes. We already know that when we increase the area over which force is applied, the pressure decreases. Similarly, a decrease in contact area increases the pressure. This thing works in terms of air also. When we increase the volume on surface, on normally surface, it has to be area, but in terms of gas, because gas is always filled inside a container, so container has volume. So greater the volume, lower the pressure. Less the volume, higher the pressure. When you try to fill air in your cycle using a pump, when you press the pump, air is compressed. Hence, this compressed air is able to get inside the tire. Guns have been around for an incredibly long time, and they started with the cannon. A cannon is a remarkably simple device. It consists of a strong metal tube closed at one end. There is a small hole for a fuse drilled into the tube.
When you load gunpowder into the tube from the open end of the cannon and then insert a cannonball so that the gunpowder and the ball are pressed against the closed end. You stick a fuse in the small hole and light it to ignite the gunpowder. The explosion shoots the cannonball away from the cannon at very high speed. Actually, the explosion created a huge amount of gases inside the tube, which were trapped in a very small space, creating a huge pressure. These gases, when tried to release from the open end of the tube, transferred their energy to the metal cannonball, and it does the required destruction. Our Earth is surrounded by a layer of air called the atmosphere. This atmosphere exerts pressure on all objects. The pressure exerted by the weight of the air on an object is called atmospheric pressure. The air in the atmosphere reaches up a height of nearly 30 km, exerting a lot of pressure on the Earth. Have you ever wondered why we don't get crushed under this weight? The reason is that the pressure exerted by our body is equal to the pressure exerted by the atmosphere on our body. This nullifies the effect of atmospheric pressure. This is the main reason why when a mountaineer goes on the higher altitude, when they move to the higher altitude, they have to use either oxygen cylinder or other ways to make sure that the pressure doesn't decrease too much on their body. If the pressure decreases, then blood may come out of their nose or some other joints. Atmospheric pressure at a place is the force exerted by the weight of the air column about that place. The height and weight of the air column decreases as we go up. Therefore, the atmospheric pressure also reduces as we go to the higher places. Hence, the atmospheric pressure at the place depends on its altitude. Now, what are the effects of atmospheric pressure? For example, as we go higher up on the mountains, we find that our ears pop and we need to breathe in more often than we breathe at lower altitudes. This happens because the air pressure around our ears decreases. This causes an imbalancing between the pressure inside and outside our ears, leading to popping of the ears. When you go on spiritual journeys like to Vaishno Devis or Kedarnath, you might have heard about few persons were not feeling comfortable. They were not able to breathe properly. This also happens because on lower higher altitudes, the presence of oxygen gas is lower than as compared to the sea level. The force or the pressure exerted by the atmosphere is very huge. This was demonstrated by a German physicist and engineer by the name Otto von Guericke. He took two semicircular copper balls and fitted them together to form a sphere. Then he sucked all the air from the sphere using a suction pump to create a vacuum inside the sphere. The two balls were now held together only due to the atmospheric pressure.
Then he tried to separate the two balls by getting them pulled apart by a team of 8 horses on each side. The balls remained held tightly together due to the atmospheric pressure and did not separate. This proved the enormous force of atmospheric pressure. In the image, you can see a huge amount of weight is on the ball, but the ball is not breaking, or the atmospheric pressure is making sure that the two balls are joined together. In another example, you can find you must have seen these types of tankers when they transport petrol or petroleum products from one place to another using the railways network. If in such a huge tank, if we remove the pressure, if we remove the air inside it, if we create the pressure, like remember what we did in the drum, same thing can happen here also. Mercury barometer is the simplest device to measure atmospheric pressure at a location. It consists of a glass tube closed at one end, immersed in a container filled with mercury. Because of the atmospheric pressure, mercury rises in the tube, and the level of mercury helps us to measure the atmospheric pressure. In the video description section, you will find a link. Using it, you can study more about barometers.